Welcome, learners. Today we are continuing the topic of air and combustion. In the previous lesson, we learned about experiment used to determine the percentage of active air. We learned about burning candle in a fixed volume of air and oxidation of copper in a fixed volume of air. Today we are looking at rusting of iron in a fixed volume of air and smoldering of phosphorus in a fixed volume of air. Now, the first one we begin it here is rusting of iron in a fixed volume of air. We define what is rusting. Rusting is the corrosion of iron due to reaction with atmospheric oxygen and water. The setup diagram below shows experiments used to determine the percentage of active air. Now, this one is a setup experiment at the start of experiments, and this one is at the end of the experiments. So at the start of experiments, we have a trough, which is this one here. You place inside there water, then you invert a gas jet over the water. The gas jet contains a certain volume of air, like X centimeters cubed. So this one is a graduated gas jet. Then this one is iron fillings here. Now, it is always advisable to note that before placing iron fillings on the gas jet, it is advisable that the gas jet is made wet so as to ensure iron fillings stick on the wet surface. Now, the experiment is left for 48 hours. Then the observation that will be made after 48 hours will be: 1. A brown coat is formed on the iron surface, or you can say gray iron fillings changes to brown. The reason for that observation is the iron reacts with oxygen and water to form hydrated iron trioxide, which is rust, which is the brown coat. Now, solution number 2, we say the level of water rises in the gas jet, or the level of water drops in the trough. Now, the reason for that observation is the moist iron utilizes oxygen in the gas jet for rusting, hence creating a partial vacuum in which water in the trough rises to occupy the volume occupied by the oxygen. So at the end of the experiment, you find that the water, we have said here, water rises in the gas jet, water drops in the trough. So at the end of the experiment, what we're going to have here is hydrated iron trioxide. The volume remaining will be Y centimeters cubed. Now, points to note about these experiments. Sometimes may be told to suggest ways in which experiment can be made to occur faster. You can say by addition of salt to the water, or by addition of acidic solution into the mixture. Now, the percentage of active air from this experiment is always obtained by taking the initial volume minus final volume over initial volume times 100%. Now, this experiment, we may not get the actual percentage of active air, so we may have what they call source of errors. One is iron may not react with all the oxygen after 48 hours. Now, the next experiment we want to look at is called smoldering phosphorus in a fixed volume of air. Now, we have several types of phosphorus. We have white, we have yellow, and we have red phosphorus. Now, white and yellow phosphorus usually smolders in air, or you say it reacts spontaneously with oxygen in air to form white fumes. Now, precaution taken during the experiments is avoid inhaling white fumes. Reason: because they are poisonous. Number 2, now, note for this experiment is white phosphorus should not be allowed to come near the walls of the gas jet so that the walls do not stop the smoldering process. Now, the setup diagram below shows an experiment used by students to determine the percentage of active air by using phosphorus. So this is a setup experiment at the start of experiments, and this one is at the end of experiments. So at the start of experiments, you have this is trough. we have this one is water, and then this you have a platinum wire. This one is a gasture, which contains a certain volume of air, like let me say air centimeters cubed. And then this one is phosphorus here. This one is phosphorus. So now this one is heat here. The platinum wire is heated here because the platinum wire is heated here instead of heating phosphorus directly. The reason is because phosphorus explodes when heated directly, as the heat is conducted slowly to the phosphorus so that it readily combines with oxygen. Now, the observation made during the experiment, is white fumes are formed. Reason is because phosphorus smolders in the presence of oxygen to form oxides of phosphorus, that is phosphorus 5 oxide and phosphorus 3 oxide, which appear as white fumes. The equation for the formation of white fumes is phosphorus plus oxygen in excess RO phosphorus 5 oxide. Next one is phosphorus plus oxygen, that is limited oxygen, RO phosphorus 3 oxide. Now, observation made at the end of experiments is white fumes disappear. The reason is because the oxides of phosphorus dissolve in water to form an acidic solution. 2. Level of water rises in the gasture. Reason: phosphorus reacts with oxygen in the gasture, creating a space in which water in the trough rises to occupy. So the setup at the end of experiment is this one here. We have said water drops in the gasture and rises inside here. Then the phosphorus is no longer here and the white fumes no longer here. So at the end of experiment here, this solution is acidic here. It's made of phosphoric 5 acid and phosphoric 3 acid. Now, points to note from this experiment is phosphorus is stored under paraffin or in airtight conditions because phosphorus readily reacts with oxygen to form oxide of phosphorus. Now, point number 2 is the experimental value may not be equal to theoretical value. Reason: because phosphorus may not react to all the oxygen in air. The percentage of active air is obtained by initial volume minus final volume divided by initial volume times 100%. Looking at the experiment used to determine the percent of active air, next we want to look at experiment that demonstrates the presence of carbon dioxide and water vapor in air. The first one to begin it is experiment that demonstrates presence of carbon dioxide in air. That is the reagent used here is called lime water, chemical name is calcium hydroxide. Description for that experiment is: pass air through lime water, that is calcium hydroxide, continuously. The formation of a white precipitate indicates the presence of carbon dioxide in air. The experiment diagram below shows an experiment used to determine the presence of carbon dioxide in air. So what happens in this experiment here is tap water, which is tap water, is allowed into the aspirator. This one is called the aspirator here. It's called the aspirator. This is called the aspirator. Now, when tap water is allowed into the aspirator, the tap water displaces air out of the aspirator and bubble it through calcium hydroxide here. So here we have what is called calcium hydroxide in this boiling tube here. So this is a boiling tube, and this is a lime water, is calcium hydroxide. So the observation that will be made in the boiling tube is a white precipitate is formed. Now, reason for the formation of white precipitate is carbon dioxide in air reacts with calcium hydroxide to form insoluble calcium carbonate. The equation for the formation of the white precipitate in the boiling tube is carbon dioxide plus calcium hydroxide, RO, calcium carbonate plus water. Experiment we want to look at is experiment used to demonstrate the presence of water in air. The reagent used here is anhydrous calcium chloride. Description for that experiment is: pass air continuously through a U-tube containing anhydrous calcium chloride. If the anhydrous calcium chloride becomes wet or forms a solution, then it indicates the presence of water vapor in air. The diagram below shows an experiment used to determine the presence of water vapor in air. Now, in this setup experiment, this one is called aspirator here. This is a tap. So when this tap is open, when this tap is opened, the tap water in the aspirator is allowed to flow out in order to create a suction force which draws air through the U-tube. So air is drawn through the U-tube here. This U-tube contains anhydrous calcium chloride. Then, because you have said air contains water, the anhydrous calcium chloride will absorb water in air and either becomes wet here or forms a solution. So observation made in the U-tube after some time is a solution is formed. Reason: anhydrous calcium chloride absorb water from the air and dissolve in it to form a solution. Points to note from this experiment is anhydrous calcium chloride is a deliquescent substance. What is a deliquescent substance? This is one which, when exposed to the atmosphere, absorbs water and forms a solution. Other substances which are deliquescent include zinc chloride, anhydrous iron 3 chloride, and magnesium chloride. Now our next topic is rusting. In rusting, you're supposed to know what is rusting, condition necessary for rusting to occur, and the factors that accelerate rusting, and then lastly, how to prevent rusting. So we begin by looking at what is rusting. Rusting is the corrosion of iron due to reaction with atmospheric oxygen and water. Now, observation made during rusting is a brown coat is formed on the iron surface. Now, the reason for the formation of the brown coat is iron reacts with oxygen and water to form hydrated iron 3 oxide. The chemical name for the brown coat is hydrated iron 3 oxide. The common name is rust. So therefore, the condition necessary for rusting to occur is oxygen and water. Equation for the formation of the brown coat: we have two equations that take place simultaneously. The first equation is iron plus oxygen, RO, iron 3 oxide. The next one is iron 3 oxide plus water gives you hydrated iron 3 oxide. The general equation becomes iron plus oxygen plus water, RO, hydrated iron 3 oxide. The factors that accelerate rusting are salty condition, acidic condition, and high temperature. Now, methods of preventing rusting are oiling and greasing, painting, alloying, tin plating, galvanization, and then sacrificial methods. Now, we want to look at some of the key things you're supposed to know under this one here. Points to note. What is sacrificial method? This one is an arrangement in which a more reactive element, e.g. magnesium or zinc, is attached to the iron surface so that the more reactive element corrodes instead of iron. Now, point number two, oiling and greasing is usually applied in moving parts.